Hello students, welcome to Topper Learning. In today's webinar, we are going to see the CBSE Mathematics board paper. In that, what we are going to see, the first one will be the familiarity with the new typology of questions, and the second one will be explaining every question type with an example. Now, to understand the new typology, first we will see the revised pattern, okay? Of 2020 and 2021. So the revised pattern consists of total 36 questions, and your entire paper is divided into two parts, part A and part B. Okay. In the part A, there are two sections, section 1 and 2, and in part B, there will be three sections, 3, 4, and 5. So the new typology which is introduced is in the section 2. Okay. This section 2 comprises of four questions of 4 marks. Each. Okay. So this is the question of case study. So this is the new typology. So we will understand what is case study. So for that, we will understand the three things. What is case study? The question based on the case studies are some real life examples. Okay. And the questions are asked based on a given paragraph. Then there will be total 5 MCQs. They are asked on the basis of the given paragraph. So this is all about your case study. So to understand this in a better way, we will see an example. So this is the case study of relay race. So first we will read the complete paragraph. What the paragraph says: on sports day, a relay race of 400 meter has been conducted by the school to measure the exact time took by each group of students. A stopwatch was used and the timing were recorded in the tabular form. So in this tabular form, all the data is recorded. Okay, so the first row is for time in second, and the second row is number of groups. Okay, so based on this case study, there will be total 5 MCQs. You have to attempt only 4. So each case study consists of 4 marks. So we will see the first MCQ. So the first MCQ says that you have to estimate the median time taken by a group to finish the race. So basically, you have to find out the median of the group data, and the classes are continuous. Okay. So to find out the median, first we have to find out the cumulative frequency. Okay. So this is the cumulative frequency table. The column of time and the number of groups is already given in the question. Okay. You have to find out the cumulative frequency. So how will you find out? First, we will write down the first frequency, that is 2. Now we will add the next frequency to it. So this will be 2 plus 5, that is equal to 7. Now the next is 7 plus 4, that is equal to 11. Then 11 plus 3, that is equal to 14. Then 14 plus 1 will be equal to 15. Okay. So the total number of frequency is equal to 15. Okay. So this is the first step. Whenever you are finding out the median of the group data when the classes are continuous. Okay, now the next thing is, here the value of n is 15. Okay, now what you will do, you will find out the value of n by 2, which is equal to 7.5. Okay, now we have to find out the median class. Now here, the value of n by 2 is 7.5. So the cumulative frequency just after 7.5 is 11. So we'll see here. So just after 7.5. So here the 7 is there, 7.5. So after 7.5, the next cumulative frequency will be 11. Okay. So we will see the class of this cumulative frequency, which is 160 to 180. So the median class will be 160 to 180. Okay. Now we will write down all the values which are there in the formula of median. So this is the small l. So lower limit of the median class, which is 160. H is the class width, which is 180 minus 160. So 20. And we already know that is 15. Now we will see what is C. C is the cumulative frequency before the median class. So the median class is 160 to 180. So before that, the cumulative frequency is 7. So we'll write down 7. And F is the frequency of the median class, that is 4. Okay. So now we will find out the median. So for median, first we will write down the formula of median, which is equal to L plus H into N by 2 minus C divided by F. Now we will substitute all the values. So the value of L is 160, the value of H is 20, N by 2 is 7.5, value of C is 7, and the value of F is 4. So if I do the calculation, the value which I'll get is 167.5 seconds, okay? So from all the options, the correct option is option A, okay? So this is your correct option. Now we will move on to the next MCQ, which says that what will be the upper limit of the model class, okay? So first of all, to find out the upper limit of the model class, we have to find out what is model class, okay? So for that, this is the table which is already given in the question. So in the table, we will see what is the highest frequency. So here the highest frequency is 5. So we will see the class of it, that is 140 to 160. So the model class is 140 to 160 as it has the highest frequency, that is 5. Okay. So we have to find out its upper limit. So upper limit will be what? 160. So from all the options, the correct option is option B. Okay. Now we will move on to the third MCQ, which says that which of the following are the major of central tendency. This is very easy question, so you can say the answer for this. We already know mean, median, mode, all are known as majors of central tendency. So the correct option will be option D. Okay. Now we will move on to the question number 4, which says that the sum of the lower limit of median class and model class is dash. Okay. So you already know what is median class because we found out in the previous question, and we already know what is model class. So we'll just write down the values. The median class is 160 to 180 and the model class is 140 to 160. Okay. Now we have to find out the sum of lower limits. So first we will write down the lower limits of each of the class. So the lower limit of the median class is 160 and the lower limit of the model class is 140. Okay. So the sum will be 160 plus 140. That is equal to 300. So the correct option is option C. Okay. So I hope so you are understanding all the questions and the solutions properly. Now we will move on to the next question, next MCQ, that is the last one. How many groups finish the race within 3 minutes? Okay. Within 3 minutes means less than 3 minutes. Okay. This you have to be careful about this. Okay. Now we know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So 3 minute will be equal to 180 seconds. So you have to find out the number of groups which finishes the race before 180 minutes. Okay. So the value will be what? You will add all the frequency, 2 plus 5 plus 4. Now here 180 is the upper limit. So it will be not included in the class. So you can take till here. Okay. So 2 plus 5 plus 4 will be 11. So 11 groups finish the race in 3 minutes. Okay. So from all the options, the correct option is option D. So there were total 5 questions. So in the question paper, you have to attempt only 4 MCQs. Okay. One MCQ will be given as a option. So it can, each MCQ will consist of 1 mark. So the total case study will be for 4 marks. Okay. Now what we will do, we will see the questions of each typology. Okay, so the first will be of 1 mark question. So we will see one example for this. Now the question says that the first and the last term of an AP are 1 and 11. If the sum of all its terms is 36, then find the number of terms in the AP. Okay, so this type of question will be asked for 1 mark. So now we will start our solution. So what the solution says, first of all, we will write down all the details which are given in the question. So in the question, it is given that the first and the last term of an AP are 1 and 11. So we'll write down A is equal to 1 and the last term is L. Now, one more thing is given. Sum of all its term is 36. So SN is equal to 36. It is also given to you. Okay. Now you have to find out the number of terms in the AP. Okay. So basically you have to find out the value of N. So for that, you should know the formula of SN. Now here the first and the last term is given. So we will use the formula of SN, which includes A and L. So the formula is N by 2 into A plus L. Now we will substitute all the values. So if we'll substitute all the values, the value of N will be 36 upon 6, and that is equal to 6. So basically we have to find out the value of N only. So we'll write down the solution. Thus the number of terms in the AP is 6. Okay. So this was your solution of 1 mark question. We will see one more example of 1 mark question. So the next question says that in the given figure, so first we will see what is the figure. So this is your figure. In this, AR is 5 centimeter, BR is 4 centimeter, AC is 11 centimeter. You have to find out the value of BC. Okay, this thing you have to find out. So we will start our solution. So first we will write down what all the things which are given in the question. So AR is 5, BR is 4, and AC is 11 centimeter. That is given to you. Now here we will use one property which says that we know that the tangent drawn from a point outside a circle are equal in length. Okay, by using this, we can say that AR is equal to AQ, BR is equal to BP, and PC is equal to QC. Okay, by using this property. Now, the value of PC is equal to QC. Okay, so this is value of PC and this will be equal to QC. Okay, now if I want to find out the value of PC, so I can find out the value for QC also because they both are equal. So QC is what? AC minus AQ, correct? So the value of AC is what? 11, and the value of AQ is what? 5 centimeter, because it is equal to AR. So the value for PC is 6 centimeter. Okay, so we got the value for PC as 6 centimeter. Now we have to find out the complete length of BC. So basically BC is what? This is BP plus PC. Okay, so the value of BP is 4 centimeter and the value of PC we already found out 6 centimeter. So the value of BC is 10 centimeter. Okay, so this was very easy question. Just you should know the property. Otherwise you will not be able to solve this question. Okay. Now, so this was about 1 mark question. Now we will move on to the next type of question, that is of 2 marks question. So we will see an example. So the question says that show that the tangents at the end point of a diameter of a circle are parallel. Okay, so for this, first you have to draw an image. Okay, so this is the image. So first we have to elaborate this image. What this image says that AB is the diameter of the given circle, okay, and PQ and RS be the tangent lines drawn to the circle at point A and at point B. So this was all about the image, because we have to show that the tangents at the end point of a diameter of a circle are parallel. Okay, so after this, we know one theorem, that tangent at a point to a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. Okay, so basically we found out this angles as the 90 degree. Okay, so therefore AB will be what? Perpendicular to both the tangents RS and PQ, correct? So from that we got PAB is equal to 90 degree and ABS equal to 90 degree. So since both are 90 degrees, so they are equal. Now we will see both the angles. Now the first angle is PAB, correct? And the second angle is ABS. So this is a pair of angle. So that pair of angle is alternate angle. So by using the converse of alternate interior angle, we can say that PQ is parallel to RS. So this was the only thing we have to prove in the question. Okay, correct? So I hope so you understood this solution. Okay, so this was the type of 2 mark question. Now we will move on to the next type, that is 3 marks question. Okay, so the question says that the sum of the numerator and the denominator of a fraction is 8. If 3 is added to both the numerator and the denominator, the fraction becomes 3/4. You have to find the fraction. So basically in this question, there are some conditions. You have to use those conditions and find out the value of fraction. Okay, so this question, first we have to find out this question will belong to which chapter. So this question belongs to linear equation in two variable. Okay, so to start with the solution, let the fraction be x/y. Okay, basically we have to find out the fraction only. We are assuming that fraction to be x/y. Okay, now the first condition is the sum of the numerator and the denominator of a fraction is 8. So obviously numerator is x and the denominator is y. So x + y is 8. This is according to the first condition. Okay, now the second condition is if 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, the fraction will become 3/4. So we'll add 3 to both numerator and denominator. So it will be equal to 3/4. Now what we will do, we will simplify the equation. So this will be 4x + 12 is equal to 3y + 9. Now 4x will be as it is. Now 3y will come here. And this will be 9 - 12, which is equal to -3. We got two equations, 1 and 2. Okay, now we have to solve these two equations simultaneously. Now here you can see that the coefficient of y is -3. And here the coefficient of y is 1. So we will make this coefficient as 3. Okay. For this, we will multiply equation 1/3. So we get 3x + 3y is equal to 24. So what we will do, we will add equation 2 and 3. So by adding this, we will get 7x is equal to 21. So the value of x is 3. Now we will substitute this value of x 3 in the equation 1. So the value of y will be 8 - x, that is equal to 8 - 3, that is equal to 5. So we got both the values, x as 3 and y as 5. So the fraction is 3/5. So this was the solution of 3-mark question. Okay, hope so you understood the solution. Now what we will do, we will quickly move on to the next typology of question that will be of 4 marks. But we already completed the case study question. And that will be asked for 4 marks. Now we will move on to the next typology or the next pattern of question that will be for 5-mark question. Okay. So we will see an example. So the question says that by increasing the list price of a book by rupees 10, a person can buy 10 less book for rupees 1200. Okay. You have to find the original list price of the book. Okay, so first of all, we have to understand this question belongs to which chapter. So this question is belonging to the chapter quadratic equation. Okay, now we will start the solution. So the first thing is by increasing the list price of a book by rupees 10, a person can buy 10 less book for rupees this. Okay, so first of all, we will take the original list price. So first of all, we will assume that the original list price of a book is rupees X. So obviously the number of books purchased will be 1200 by X. Okay. Now if I'll increase the list price of a book by 10. Okay. So the person can buy 10 less book for rupees 1200. Okay. So if I'll increase the price by 10. Okay. So obviously, the number of books purchased will be 1200 upon x plus 10. Okay, when the list price was x, the person can buy the book number of books as 1200 by x. If I increase the list price by 10, so obviously, a person can buy 1200 upon x plus 10 books. Okay, now the condition is by increasing the list price of a book by rupees 10, a person can buy 10 less book for rupees 1200. So this condition can be written as this: 1200 upon x minus 1200 upon x plus 10, and that is equal to 10. Now we have to simplify this. From this we will take out 1200 common, so in the bracket 1 upon x minus 1 upon x plus 10, and that will be equal to 10. Now here we will simplify this. So here the xx gets cancelled. Now here 10 and 10 gets cancelled. So the simplified equation will be 1200 is equal to x into x plus 10. Now we will simplify this. So this will become a quadratic equation. Now we have to factorize this. So you have to find out the factors of 1200 in such a way that if you'll add or subtract, you should get 10. So the factors are 40 and 30. Okay, so the value of x is minus 40 or x is equal to 30. So we have to see, x is what? The list price of a book. Obviously, it can't be negative, correct? So therefore, the original list price of the book is rupees 30. Okay, so in this similar way, you have to solve such type of problems. Okay, so this was the type of 5 marks question. Hope so you understood all the solutions and all the typologies very nicely. Okay, so now I will end my webinar here only. So all the best for your exam, and thank you.